In Unreal Engine, when exporting the face mesh, be sure to select Level of Details checkbox. In Blender, import face mesh. Delete root armature. Now delete leftover empties. Delete these meshes. For a computer with lower specs, choose LOD with fewer trees. Delete vertex groups from remaining meshes. Remove all materials. Select Load to Face Mesh and go to Edit Mode. Detach Head Mesh and rename it Hide Head Load to. Let's delete remaining mesh. Unhide Face Mesh Load 0, then proceed in the same way. This part is only useful if you want to visualize the inside of the mouse, so let me delete it. Select these guys, separate and name them. Same thing with the tongue and lower teeth. Select remaining empty vertices and delete. Go on with eyeballs. Then with these parts of the inside of the eyes. Let me delete these parts. Now select these parts, then separate and name them. Select these elements and delete. Lastly, rename eyelashes. Now let's delete all of the unused materials. Go to Orphan Data, then Purge. All clear. Let's show everything. Now select all and export as FBX. Open MetaHuman with armature that we set in MetaHuman to Blender tutorial. Link is in the description. Delete the head and the eyes. Import head mesh FBX that we exported earlier. Put all meshes in a new collection. Hide head load 0 mesh. Delete or hide any rig if present. Let me append some materials. You can watch MetaHuman shading tutorials on my channel if you don't know how to set up materials. Let me select the head mesh and apply the corresponding material. Hide the head mesh. Now select mouth upper mesh and apply mouth material. We have some problems with the textures. Actually, let me delete these objects. Instead, let me add similar meshes of the eyes, hair, and mouth that I made earlier, and I'll explain what is what along the way. Put imported objects in the head collection. Let me show you what was added. Now let's look at node structures of some materials. You can download all these materials but without textures from the link in the description. Here is how I placed UV islands of the gums. For more in-depth information about materials and shading in general, you can check shading playlist on my channel. Unhide the head load 2 mesh. To start from clean slate, delete FK, tweak and root bone collections if present. For the next step, Rigify add-on must be enabled. Add a human metallic armature. Increase scale for all axes. Try to approximately match face bones with the face mesh in the front view. Scale in X and Z axes. And move only up and down. Do not move sideways. Now try matching the bones with the face mesh from the side view. Here you can move bones in Z and Y axes. Apply scale. Enable in front in viewport display options. Select and delete all but face bones from the metallic armature. In object mode, select face metallic bones, then shift select root bones and join. In edit mode, parent the face bone to the head bone with keep offset. Let me check the connection. Generate rig. We have an error, but it's relatively easy to fix. This error appears if you've completed the Rig MetaHuman with Rigify tutorial and beyond. Go to Pose mode. Select Upper Arm L-Bone. Go to Bone Properties tab. Down below, assign the bone to corresponding FK and Twig collections. Let's uncheck local location. Same story with the right arm. Go on with the left leg. Uncheck local location. Check separate IK toe. Same thing with the right leg. Continue with spine 01. Uncheck control in pelvis. Carry on with neck 01. Check connect chain. Select the left clavicle and change its widget type to shoulder. Same with the right clavicle. Let's leave left metacarpal bone as it is. Assign twig collection to fingers. Let me activate IK control and IK local location on the left hand to see the difference. Similar story with the right fingers, but let me deactivate the options. Regenerate rig. The rig is working, but IK controllers cannot be hidden from the user interface. Let's troubleshoot this inconvenience. Select root armature and activate edit mode. Let's start with the left leg. Select bones with region select and assign them to appropriate bone collection. In this case, left leg IK. Same thing with the right leg. Now select pelvis, spine, neck, hand and clavicle bones. Assign them to torso bone collection. Let's enlarge the hand bone to make hand IK controller bigger. Select the left hand, lower arm and upper arm bones and assign them to left arm IK bone collection. Similar story with the right arm. Select all fingers and assign them to fingers bone collection. Regenerate rig. Now all buttons are working properly. The last issue is that in pose mode all of the controllers are in default color. Let's fix this. Select the root armature and add 6 color sets. Rename and give each set a different color. Regenerate rig. As you can see, now each set has a different color. Go to object mode. Select root armature and go to edit mode. Select and hide all bones except the facial bones. In the front view, select half of the facial bones and hide them. Make sure X-axis mirroring is enabled. Activate face snapping and start moving heads and tails of bones. Always region select facial bone joints to avoid accidental separation of bones. Move every joint to snap it to the face except those on the center line. Hide this bone for now. Also, let's hide eyelashes and tear line. Let's quickly place the eye bones around the eye. We will come back to them in a minute. Place these bones below the eyebrow. And these are eyebrow bones. Let's switch to solid preview. Continue region selecting and moving joints around the eye until the eye bones are evenly separated and closely follow the shape of the eyelids. This joint is for adjusting the rotation axis of the jaw. Physically, it is around here, but for animation purposes, it's better to have it somewhere here. Let's quickly position the ear bones. Hide the bones except those in the center of the face. Go to side view, deactivate snapping, and then move the joints to match the profile of the face. Reveal hidden bones. Select teeth and tongue bones, then hide unselected. Hide the head mesh. Place the teeth bones in the correct places. Hide the teeth meshes. Position the tongue bones in the correct place. Reveal hidden bones. Go to object mode. Let's hide the root armature for a minute. Here apparently we have a problem. Let me delete this inside object to make our life a little bit easier. Select the right eyeball and go to shading tab. Rename the eyeball material, then duplicate it, and then rename duplicated material as well. Adjust mapping location and rotation. Fine-tune the transparency transition with these black and white sliders. Cool, the problem has gone. Let's combine irises and eyeballs. With the left eyeball selected, go to edit mode. Select tip of the eye, then press Shift S, then cursor to select it. Go to object mode, select root armature and go to edit mode. Select the tail of the left eye bone, then press Shift S and selection to cursor. Go to object mode, select the eyeball mesh, then go to object, then set origin to center of mass. Press Shift S, then cursor to select it. Select the root armature and go to edit mode. Select the head of the left eye bone, then press Shift S, then selection to cursor. Now select the left eye bone, then activate individual origins and make it bigger. Go to object mode. Upgrade face rig, then regenerate rig. Hide the root armature. Show face and torso layers. Select the tongue mesh, then shift select the rig, then press Ctrl P and parent with automatic weights. Unhide the head mesh, select it, then shift select the rig and parent with automatic weights. Hide the head mesh, shift select eyeballs, the upper and lower teeth, hair and lastly the rig. Then press Ctrl P and set parent with empty groups. Select the left eyeball. Go to edit mode, select all vertices. In vertex groups, find the left eye deformation bone and assign the mesh. Same procedure with the right eye. Assign this upper mouth mesh to top teeth deformation bone. And this one to bottom teeth. Assign the hair mesh to the head deformation bone. Let's test what we've done so far. Not bad, but we can do better. In the next tutorial, we will learn to weight paint the face.